Hello, and welcome to another episode of my reviewer series for civil engineering topics focusing on geotechnical engineering problems. For today's situation, two footings rest in a layer of sand 2.7 meters thick. The bottoms of the footings are 0.9 meters below the ground surface, and beneath the sand layer is a 1.8 meter thick clay layer. Underneath the clay layer is a solid rock, and the water table is at a depth of 1.8 meters below the ground surface. If we are to put that in our figure, ito ang magiging measurement niya. With that, we are to determine the following. First, the stress increase below footing A with a base of 1.5 by 1.5 meters at the center of the clay layer, assuming that the pressure beneath footing A is spread at an angle of 2V1H. Second, the size of footing B so that the settlement and clay layer is the same beneath footing A and B. And third, the settlement beneath footing A. So for this one, we must first recognize the pressure spread beneath the given footings in order for us to determine kung paano natin kukunin yung stress increase. And take note, yung increase na sinasabi dito is due to the load na in-apply ng footing natin. In order to solve for that, we will utilize the formula force over area. Given na tayo ng added force na 450 kilonewtons. And since ang inahanap na increase ay sa point C, which is located sa mid-height ng clay layer, kailangan muna natin ma-determine kung ano yung affected area at that point, or yung area na nakaka-experience nung stress increase. And malalaman natin yun by using our assumption that the pressure spread is distributed at an angle of 2V1H. Para sa mga di familiar, this is just a ratio for the measurement of spread. So V stands for vertical, and H stands for horizontal. To help you visualize, pansinin yung trapezoid na mabubuo sa ilalim ng footing A. Bale, yung length increase in one side of the area is half of the increase of the vertical or the height of the point observed from the base of the footing. So to determine our area measurements, dapat alamin muna natin yung vertical height. And medyo madali na lang naman to, kasi given the figure, add lang natin yung dalawang 0.9 from the base of footing, tapos alam natin na mid-height ng clay is 1.8 divided by 2, which is also 0.9. Therefore, in total height is 2.7. So if ang vertical natin is 2.7 meters, ang horizontal increase naman natin is just 2.7 divided by 2, which is just equal to 1.35. For the other side of this corner, meron ding increase na 1.35. And it is also stated na ang dimension ng footing natin is 1.5 on each side of the square. Pag in-add natin yun, ang magiging sides ng square area sa level ng layer na yun is 4.2 meters. Therefore, given the values na nakuha natin, ang increase at that point is equal to 450 kilonewtons divided by the area of 4.2 squared. That gives us the value of 25.51 kilonewtons per meter squared or kilopascals. Up next, for our second problem, in order to determine the size of footing B, meron tayong condition na dapat yung settlement ng both footings sa clay layer ay dapat equal. And as we proceed, discuss ko muna saglit kung paano natin mayu-utilize tong condition na to. As we all know, there are different types of settlement depending sa condition ng soil. We have the immediate settlement, wherein ito yung nagaganap pag instantaneous pressure ang in-apply or di pa nagtatagal yung load na pinatong sa soil. At this point, yung compression na nag-occur is due to elastic deformation pa lang. As for primary consolidation settlement, ito naman yung point na na-reach na ng affected soil yung pag-expel ng pore water. Bale dito, meron tayong dalawang conditions, which are normally consolidated and over-consolidated state. And under over-consolidated state naman, meron din dalawang conditions, which is yung una, is yung pre-consolidated stress is less than the total stress experienced after pressure increase. And yung pangalawa naman, is yung pre-consolidated stress is greater naman than the total stress after pressure increase. Lastly, for secondary consolidation, this occurs once na matapos na yung primary consolidation. At this point, soil creep na lang yung nagaganap or yung sobrang bagal na pagbaba ng lupa dahil sa loading. So, given these conditions, paano natin malalaman kung alin yung gagamitin sa problem? Kasi kung babalikan natin yung question, wala naman naka-indicate na state of settlement. Ang haba-haba ng discuss natin pero wala naman palang condition, no? For this kind of situation, may pwede pa rin naman tayong gawin na diskarte. Ang gagawin lang natin is, iti-check lang natin kung sa formula na gagamitin, present lahat ng unknowns. Kasi wala naman specified condition eh. And iba-iba rin naman yung given sa figure natin. So, starting with the immediate settlement, yung B is the width of the footing, while yung Q naman is the net pressure experienced at the base. So far, meron tayong dalawang values. Pero sa third variable natin, yung mu symbol stands for the Poisson's ratio, which is wala sa figure natin. So, eliminate na natin si formula number 1. For the second equation, H stands for the height of the clay layer, which in our figure is measured 1.8 meters. Yung C sub C naman, yan yung compression index natin, which is also present sa figure. E sub O is the initial void ratio ng clay layer. And for our last two variables, yung P sub 0 is the initial effective stress, which is solvable naman by computing the total stress minus pore water pressures sa mid-height ng clay layer. And yung delta P is nasagutan na natin sa question number 1. Therefore, we can say that this formula is very compatible for determining the settlement condition and for solving the soil settlement. Pero just to be sure, check din natin yung ibang formulas if meron ding iba pang possible na magamit. For the third formula, mapapansin natin na naiba na agad siya sa variable na C sub S, or also known as swell index. So, matik, eliminate na rin natin to. And for the last one, C sub alpha stands for secondary compression index, which is also again, not present in our figure. Therefore, final na talaga na si formula 2 ang gagamitin natin for our settlement condition. So, going back, ang sabi sa question is dapat equal yung settlements sa ilalim ng footing A at footing B. And upon writing our formula, bago nyo siya isalpak sa calculator, pansinin nyo muna na meron tayong mga variables na pwede muna natin i-cancel. Kasi ang hassle din kung yung ganyang kahaba na equation is itatype nyo pa sa calculator nyo, diba? So, yung height ng clay layer, compression index, at initial void ratio beneath both footings is pareho lang. So, pwede nyo na sila i-cancel from both sides. As for the logarithmic values, pwede nyo ilabas na lang both equations from our log function. So, masisimplify pa natin to further into this equation. Di lang yan, kasi kung kukunin natin yung initial effective pressure on both footings, same lang yung dimensions nila, so pwede na rin natin sila i-cancel. So, basically, in order for us to solve for number 2, i-equate lang pala natin yung stress increase ng footings A at footing B. So, mas madali na natin siya ilalagay sa calculator kesa yung kanina na sobrang haba pa na formula yung gagamitin. So, alam na natin na yung stress increase sa ilalim ng footing A is 25.51 kPa. Then sa footing B naman, ang given na force is 900 kilonewtons and ang unknown is yung area affected at clay mid height. Solving for this, we will get a value of 35.28 square meters. Tapos, isa pa nga pala sa need natin i-consider. Since di naman stated kung anong shape ng footing base natin, let's just assume na square din siya, since in comparison naman tayo with foot A. So, solving for the dimension of the square footing. Solve lang natin square root ng 35.28, and that gives us the side dimension of 5.9397. Take note ha, dimension pa lang yan nung area sa mid-height sa clay layer. To solve for the dimension of the base of the footing itself, balikan lang natin yung applied pressure na 2V1H. Wala naman nagbago sa vertical na height, which is 2.7 meters. So ang nadagdag lang na length on both sides of the figure is still 1.35. Given this, the side dimension of our footing B is just 5.9397 minus twice of 1.35 equal to 3.24 meters. On to the last problem. To solve for the settlement beneath footing A, salpak na lang tayo ng mga given values natin, except for P sub 0, which is the initial effective stress sa mid-height ng clay layer. So recalling our formula for effective stress, this is just equal to total stress minus pore water pressure. Solving for the total stress, summation lang tayo ng unit weight times height ng layers. So starting from the topmost, 18.5 times 1.8 plus 20.8 times 0.9 plus 18.8 times 0.9 lang, since hanggang mid-height lang dapat ng clay layer. Then to subtract, ang pore water pressure natin is unit weight ng water na 9.81 times the distance of clay mid-height from groundwater table, which is 1.8. After solving, the initial effective pressure of our figure is 51.282 kilopascals. Finally, plug na lang natin yung values natin sa settlement equation. So H is equal to 1.8, compression index is 0.3, initial void ratio is 1.03, initial effective stress is 51.282 kilopascals, and our stress increase is 25.51 kilopascals. After solving, we will get a value of 0.0466451 or 46.64 in terms of millimeters. So there you have it. This situation is finally solved.